Hello and welcome. In this video, we're going to cover four methods in terms of how to wipe your computer or hard drive. The first method that we're going to cover is how to securely wipe a Windows computer. The second method that we're going to cover is how to securely wipe a Windows computer, but for those that are going to be a little bit more paranoid. This is going to take a little bit longer, but some people want to make sure that all the data cannot be recovered. The third area that we're going to cover today is how to wipe an external USB hard drive or thumb drive, something that would connect to your computer via a USB drive. The last method that we're going to cover is an external hard drive that doesn't connect through a USB drive, but normally connects to the inside of a computer. I've added the timestamps above so that you can jump to the section that's relevant to you. But with that in mind, let's get started.
In this first method, what we will cover is how to securely wipe your computer. This is going to be a relatively simple task. So to start, what you want to do is click on the Windows button, then click on the power button, and then when you see the restart button, hold shift and then press the restart button. What this will do is it'll take you to the safe mode, where you can now reset your computer. Once the safe mode is available, click on Troubleshoot, reset this PC, then remove everything. Once the menu becomes available, click on Local Reinstall, fully clean the drive, and then finally, click Reset. This will initiate the process to reset your computer and wipe out all your old documents. And all that's left to do is to follow the simple steps when Windows becomes available. The next part we will cover is how to wipe your computer and make sure that nothing can be recovered. This process requires a USB and can be considered overkill and can take days depending on your hard drive and processor. With that in mind, part one can address most needs to securely wipe the computer. If you choose to go down this path, I recommend watching the full segment before running this process. To get started, there are a few things that you'll need to download from the internet. The first is Encryption, and the second is a Windows bootable drive. I provided a link to these in the description below. Once these are installed, we can get started by clearing the hard drive and making the current operating system unreadable if the hard drive is acquired by a third party. With that in mind, we will open up the downloads and run the Encryption setup. Encryption is an open source encryption tool that will encrypt your hard drive and make existing data unreadable if you select the right options. When the pop-up appears to give access to Encryption, click Yes. Select your language and click OK. Click I accept and then Next. Make sure Install is selected, and then click Next. Click Install. Once Encryption is done installing, click OK, Finish, and select No in regards to the tutorial. If the warning appears, click Yes and allow the computer to restart. Once Windows is done restarting, open Encryption and click Create Volume. Click the third option, Encrypt the System Partition or Entire System Drive, and then click Next. Keep normal, and then click Next. Click on Encrypt the whole drive, and then Next, and give Encryption permission by pressing Yes. If you get the warning regarding your system drive contains a non-standard partition, click Yes to allow the options to change. The area that isn't going to be covered by Encryption is generally unused by the operating system. Click on the option that is relevant to you. If you're unsure, click on Single Boot and press Next. Next, select the encryption algorithm that you would like to apply. The choices with multiple encryption names will apply multiple layers of encryption and will be useful if you're paranoid about making sure all the data is wiped. But for this tutorial, we will stick with the standard AES. The hash algorithm doesn't really matter, so we'll keep the default of SHA 256. Once you're done making your selection, click Next. This next part is really important. You want to make a very secure password over 20 characters in length. You have to type in this password one more time after this menu, so you may want to write it down temporarily and destroy the password once the process is complete. A simple password is not recommended and may defeat the purpose of this process. Once you have chosen your password, click Next. The next part is creating a random key for the encryption. In short, computers can't truly generate random numbers, so this process creates a truly random key. Once the bar is full, click Next. Click Next again. Given our intent is to wipe the computer and leave no trace behind, we don't need a rescue disk. With that in mind, check Skip the Rescue Disk Verification and click Next. Click Next again, and then OK. Now, here is the second key part that you'll have to choose. The options are asking how many times you would like to write over the current hard drive. The idea behind this is that when you delete a file, it is not truly deleted and needs to be written over several times before the file becomes completely unrecoverable. 7 is the recommended minimum for this, but you may choose 35 if you truly want to go overkill on this process. Keep in mind, a pass of 35 times can take days to complete depending on your processor and hard drive. Once you made your selection, click Next, and then click Yes. This is a key step to ensure your data is cleared. In the next menu, click Test, OK, and then Yes. This will restart your computer to make sure that the new boot system works before the encryption process begins. Once the computer restarts, you'll see a new screen asking for your password. Note that your screen may look different than mine, and that's okay. Just type in the password you previously created. If you can't remember the password, click Escape and restart the process. If you successfully typed in your password, Windows will restart and VeraCrypt will automatically let you know the pretest has been complete. Now click Encrypt. Okay, and Yes to begin the encryption process. Like I mentioned previously, it may take several days to complete. Once this is done, click Finish and close VeraCrypt. Now, go back to Downloads and open the Windows Media Creation tool. As mentioned previously, you will need a USB with at least 16 gigabytes of memory, so go ahead and plug that into your computer at this time. This process will remove any files currently on the USB, so make sure that the USB contains nothing that you like to keep. Accept the license terms when it comes up. In the next menu, click Create Installation Media, then click Next. Click Next again. Click Next again. Now select the USB you want to use for this process and click Next. This might take a while, so you can walk away while the USB gets set up. When the process is done, click Finish, then restart your computer. While your computer is restarting, press F12 or the one-time boot option hotkey that's listed at the startup. On my computer, it shows at the top right, but it can be tucked away on any corner. So if it's not F12, take a look around and see if you can see what option it is. You might have to click it many times as it starts up. If you go and reach the VeraCrypt boot menu, press Ctrl-Alt-Delete and try again. If this is done correctly, the boot options will appear. Now, select your USB drive that you selected in the Windows installation media process. For me, this is going to be the only option in UEFI boot. This will boot from the USB and start the Windows installation process. Click Next, and then Install Now. Agree to the terms and click Next. You'll want to select the second option, Custom. In this next menu, select the largest partition. For me, this will be partition 2, and then click Next. However, if you're not able to click the Next button, hold Shift and press F10. This will open up the command prompt. And then type diskpart. Then type list disk. Now, type in select disk and then the disk number that contains the bootable hard drive. This is generally the largest disk. For me, the disk I would like to select is disk 0, so I will type in select disk 0. Double check that you selected the right volume by typing list disk again. Make sure the asterisk is next to the hard drive that you like the operating system on. This will not be the USB drive. As you can see, the correct disk is selected. Next, type clean. Then type convert GPT. Close out of the command menu. Exit out of the process, click Yes, and restart the Windows install. This time it should appear as a single drive. Click that drive and then click Next. If you initially had an issue with not clicking Next, this may have to be done more than once in terms of cleaning the disk. That's okay. Just restart the process from the installation and making sure that you're booting from the USB. Now that we are done, just let Windows install itself and your computer is ready to be recycled. Now, we will cover how to securely wipe an external drive that is connected via USB. We'll use the previous USB used in our example. With that in mind, go to the SourceForge link above to download the eraser tool. This tool will write over any file many times so that it becomes unrecoverable. Once it's done installing, open the .exe file to set up eraser. Click Next and agree to the terms. Choose Typical and then install. Once the eraser is done installing, open up the eraser tool. Once it is open, right-click the middle of the white space as the video shows and select New Task. With the new menu, make sure the Run Immediately is selected and click on Add Data. In the drop-down menu, select Drive/Partition and select the drive that you would like to wipe. My USB shows up in two different locations, Hard Disk 1 and ESD-USB Drive D. Note that the drive that you would like to target may be different than mine. Once the target drive has been selected, click OK, OK again, and let the process complete. This process may take several hours to several days and is a 32 write pass by default, which is above the 7 write pass minimum. In the last part, we will cover how to wipe an external drive that does not have a USB connection. To be able to do this, you will need special hardware, as I've shown on the screen, that will allow you to connect to the drive through a USB. I've added links below for the items that I would recommend. Once you have the device that has the right connector for your particular hard drive, treat the process like the third process in this video with the eraser tool. That's it for this video, and if you like the content, please like and subscribe, and any comments below is appreciated.